So, Sheikh, I'm a Muslim in America, and I was just, following, trying to follow the Quran and the Sunnah. And in my community, there's Hanafi and Shafi'i, and of course, also a few other masjids that follow Imam Ahmad. So I'm trying to figure out which madhab should I follow. Every time someone asks me which madhab do you follow, I just say, I'm just follow the Quran and the Sunnah, and I don't want a fatwa shop or any of that. So which madhab do you advise to follow?
I really enjoy an answer because we get asked Muhammad this question so many times in the AIM conferences, Authentic Al Mission conferences, and I really enjoy it so much the way that Sheikh Uthman ibn Farooq Hafidhahullah answers that question. He says, it's the first time actually I look at it this way, which is so true, that those people who claim to be followers of these madhahib, if you actually question them regarding the madhab, they are unable to actually identify the principles of this madhab. So although they claim that they follow the Hanafi, or if you ask them to name some books actually on Hanafi madhab, they will fail you. These brothers or sisters in these masajid, they are blind followers and they are muqallideen. Again, at the end of the day, we don't want to present ourselves to say that we don't follow madhab. No, we follow the dalil, the evidence, wherever the evidence is, whoever has the evidence, whoever has qala Allah, qala Rasulullah, authentically transmitted, and istidlal also, the way that you derive the ruling from it is something that is accepted. You follow the usul al-fiqh, the fundamentals of jurisprudence in Islam, and how you al-mutlaq ala al-muqayyad al-am ala al-khat. There are certain tools which you employ to derive a ruling from an evidence. If you follow that, so shadow, the important thing is whoever does that, then you follow that person. It can be Abi Hanifa, it can be Shafi'i, it can be Malik, it can be Ahmad, it can be Thawri, Sufyan, it can be Layth ibn Sa'd, it can be Al-Awza'i, it can be Sufyan ibn Uyayna. These are also Imams. It can be Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. You see, at the end of the day, when we say La ilaha illallah, that means La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah. No one has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when I say ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, when I say that, la matbu'a bihaqqin illa Rasulullah. No one is entitled to my adherence, to follow, except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Abu Hanifa said that. Abu Hanifa said, if idha sahha al-hadithu fahuwa madhhabi. If the hadith is authentic, then it overrides my ruling. Malik said that. كُلٌ يُؤْخَذُ مِنْهُ وَيُرَدُ إِلَّا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. You can say no to anybody, to everybody, to all, except Rasulullah. You can say no to Rasulullah. Ahmad said that. لَا تَأْخُذْ مِنِّي وَلَا مِنْ الْأَوْزَاعِ وَلَا مِنَ اللَّيْثِ. Do not learn from me. Ahmad, Imam Ahmad, Ibn Hanbal. Do not take my ruling or Al-Awza'i's ruling, but خُذْ مِمَّا أَخَذْنَا مِنْ. Take from the source, which is the Sunnah. Shafi'i, if I said something and you found out that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said something different, فَرْمُوا بِقَوْلِي عَرْضَ الْحَائِطِ. Throw what I said out of the window and take what the Prophet said. This is your attitude, okay? Jazakallahu khairan, brother. Assalamu alaikum.